What's up guys and welcome back to another video. Today's video we're focusing on the Southern Hemisphere. The big news, obviously South Africa officially after 25 incredible years of Super Rugby are leaving to go join the Pro 16. It was confirmed yesterday evening that the Sharks, Lions, Bulls and Stormers would indeed be heading to the Pro 14, making it the Pro 16. Cheetahs obviously been eliminated. They've been apparently been given some assurances of taking part in a bigger tournament in South Africa, as well as obviously the Currie Cup. They say if there's a Super 8 possibility, Cheetahs will be first in line to obviously get a shot for that tournament as well. So they are trying to keep the Cheetahs happy, but we all know they are upset. Fans have mixed emotions. There's a lot of negativity in the air around Free State, and rightly so. They're missing out on a phenomenal opportunity of Pro 14 rugby where they didn't do too badly and don't deserve the boot or the treatment that they're currently getting. But unfortunately, these things happen. It was a vote by SA Rugby, and the vote was that these four teams from Super Rugby would be joining the North. Now, in other news, it also comes about that obviously the Rugby Championships also up in the air, because questions are, will it happen? Should it happen? Obviously, there's a lot of fans, myself included, want to see it happening, but we've got the question marks of South African rugby, we've got the question marks of New Zealand and the drama with the scheduling. They don't want to miss Christmas. They want to obviously still play in. Then there's talk of an agreement of finishing off the week before, rather than December 12th. So there's a lot of things going on. But now recently, Fox Sports have leaked minutes that have actually revealed New Zealand did in fact agree to play in the Rugby Championship over 6 weeks till the date of December 12th, despite them clearly stating that they are not happy at all. New Zealand Rugby CEO Mark Robinson has also stated that they obviously aren't happy with the way things are going. They want Sanzar to change this, to bring the tournament a week further so that they don't have to miss Christmas due to quarantine rules because of COVID-19, etc., etc. So there's a lot of drama going on in the air for Rugby Championship, Super Rugby. Obviously, Mark Robinson has also responded to the talk of South Africa leaving Super Rugby. Obviously, they said it was predictable, they were expecting this to happen, and now they need to act quickly as to what they're going to do next. Which brings to the next topic of the Trans-Tasman competition, or Super Rugby for the Australia, maybe Argentina, depending on what Argentina decides. But it doesn't look like that's even going to happen, because Argentina rugby has said that the players can now go overseas and play. So pretty much it's going to be Australia, New Zealand, and whoever they decide, if Pacific Island teams or Japan, whoever it might be. There's a lot of discussions going on, but there's also a lot of tension in that end of the world, because you've got Australia who are wanting more than two teams. You've got New Zealand who are wanting Australia to only have two teams. So there's a lot of question marks up in the air and back and forth from New Zealand and Australia. So, I mean, even the chairman of Rugby Australia said it's the Sanzar relationship currently is at its lowest ebb, and they need to work on it to try and see what's going on. I must go back to South African rugby pulling out of Super Rugby. SA Rugby CEO Yuri Roux stated that the reasoning for this move is because of New Zealand's decision to exclude South Africa in their future plans for next year, going because of COVID and all that. I have to kind of defend New Zealand here, because South Africa have always been in the mix of moving over to the North. It's been rumored for quite a few years now. I mean, we know it, you know it. I mean, I didn't quite get that comment. I mean, Rassie Erasmus had a strategy and a plan all along. I mean, why you go to Munster? Why you got guys on the board? Why are we still continuing, obviously, with Cheetahs and Kings? There was always a plan to grow the relationship moving to the north. So I think stating that the move, or probably the quick move, I can understand maybe going forward because of what New Zealand are planning going forward, but I wouldn't put full blame on to New Zealand rugby for that. Obviously there was deals, partnership deals with Santel for another couple of years, television rights and all that, which has now been broken, but these things happen. I mean, what do you hold on to a tournament that's really not doing great? I mean, Super Rugby has been on its way out for quite some time. Or do you spice things up a bit and change things up? I mean, New Zealand Rugby had stated how good Super Rugby Aotearoa was received. It was received with flying colours. We've seen Super Rugby AU do well. As sad as it is and as tough as it is for fans who have grown up watching Super Rugby, at the end of the day, it's a good move because it suits South Africa from a time zone point of view, from New Zealand time zone point of view. They don't have to go on long tours. And all that stuff, and you know, you're not away from your families as much, so I'm not too gutted about it. There's still obviously the question mark. South Africa's still going to be on tours in Europe. They're probably going to play a fair amount of games over in Europe before they come back. It won't be up and down. Because there's big money, and another thing with South Africa, not only time zones, it's good money for us. Taking our teams over there, with our current exchange rate on the economy, a pound to the rand is well over 20 odd bucks. So it's looking pretty healthy for these South African players. And let's face it, a lot of our guys are overseas already. So why not take our stars overseas so we don't lose players within our own provincial stances and just move forward. So you know what? It was a great time with Australia and New Zealand and Argentina as well as Japan, but you know, all good things have to come to an end. The tournament was dying out, something needed to happen, and I think a Trans-Tasman tournament which will feature Australia, New Zealand, the Pacific Island teams, maybe Japan as well, it's just going to spice things up a bit and really create something great from a provincial level for the South, and I think it will just go on and be a great tournament. So I wish those guys all the best of luck, and I will definitely be watching and covering it all, whether we're there or not. Who knows, maybe we'll have a Super 8 tournament. I think that will be absolutely epic if we can get that right. As for South Africa moving north, I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited for the challenges that the South African teams are going to have there. I think it's going to be an epic contest seeing the Sharks take on a team like Leinster and have the opportunities. I do, however, hope that moving north will give us an opportunity to enter the Champions Cup. I think that will be a fantastic boost for South African rugby to really get into the level of playing against the French and the English clubs. It will just ignite things even better, and I think it's a phenomenal move as well from that point of view. Rugby Championship still going ahead. There's no talk of that being ended. South African Rugby have confirmed that they're sticking to the Rugby Championship, also hoping to still go ahead at the end of the year. So all of that staying ahead. We're going to have the rivalry with New Zealand. We're going to have the rivalry with Australia and Argentina if Argentina stay in the Rugby Championship. So those things are all sticking about. It's just Super Rugby. And I think if you're a diehard rugby fan, you'll know that this tournament needed a spice up. And maybe this is the spice up that it's going to get. And that's going to be a benefit for Southern Hemisphere Rugby. And it will give it a good boost. And I really do wish all teams, North and South, all the best. And I hope that together we can find ways to come back to one another from a provincial level and create a Club World Cup to make it exciting and bring back those awesome rivalries between New Zealand, Australia and South Africa. It's going to be awesome. So yeah, let's just move forward, focus on the future, focus on what's new, what's better, and really hope that it works out for all the teams. I think it's a good move. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. That's going to do it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, smash that thumbs up button, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you real soon for another one. Thanks so much for watching. Stay safe and never give up. Cheers.